He collected the cash, well respected from connections with gangs. Sworn in, took an oath, never mentioned a plan. The Pope's right hand, brother to the cardinal man. Brought him in, now he's part of the scam. Understand, there's a church in every hood, and every hood has a rep. God's banker, better have that money on deck to kick upstairs so that he can answer your prayers. Or better yet, just to cancel your fears. But he never appears, he's in the big house, he's been there for years. Serving life in the Vatican, that's where he is. In the cathedral tower, laid up in one of the tiers. But got lethal power with his loyal army of kids. It's a shadow government, a state within a state, a street covenant. With everybody in the inside running it. Roberto Calvi from the P2 Lodge. Got attention from the beast trying to be too large. He was God's banker in the southeast of Italy. Used his gun to bark his mouthpiece wittily. He brought a lot of money to the church and the Pope. And started using it as cover for disbursement of dope. He had altar boys working for him and broke the code of silence. Talking loud about assignments in an open form. Now he got Interpol scoping toward him. The only time a member talks though is through evidence that's post-mortem. The Pope heard about a rise in the cops' interest and how a thing like that could take a business off hinges. Man, the worst is the witness stand. Before it gets to this, you jump on the hit list plan. So he fled out of the city. The feds nor the Holy Committee knew about him or where he was really. But you know you can't run from the arm of God. They stabbed his brother 30 times in a Vatican courtyard. Interpol tracked him to a UK inn.
You can talk to us or see God and you pay him. We can protect you, relocate your wife and kids.
They found him 8 days later, hung under a bridge. It wasn't known who did it. Even God in his own dominion has a wrath that'll take your spirit. God's banker played and his heart was in it. In life and death, God's army stays committed.